Hi, my hardworking learners. I welcome you once again to yet another interesting example as far as proof by mathematical induction is concerned. Now, in this type of proof, we are usually asked to show whether a certain mathematical expression is divisible by a certain number. So let's pick an example. Says that a proof that this particular expression 10 to the power n minus 4 is divisible by 6. So we want to show that 10 exponent 10 minus 4 can be divided by 6. And we are doing this by mathematical induction for all n belonging to the set of natural numbers. So it's still by mathematical induction. But the first thing to do is to see if it is true for the first element of the set of natural numbers. So for that, we have this for n equals 1. So what we're trying to do is to substitute 1 and see whether the resulting value can be divided by 6. If that is possible, then we conclude that yes, it is true for the first element. So substituting 1 in place of n, we're going to have 10 minus 4, which gives us 6. So you agree with me that 6 is actually divisible by 6. So the proof has been anchored. Alright, so moving forward, we assume that this particular statement is true for n equals k. So for n equals k, we are assuming. So assume that 10, so now we're talking about n equals k. So it means any place we see n in the original expression, we're going to put there with k. So n power k minus 4 is divisible by 6. Alright. Now what do you mean by it being divisible by 6? So at this point we can say that the equivalent statement of this will be that 10 to the power k minus 4 is equal to 6 say j. So where j belongs to the set of natural numbers. Now what we're trying to do is that if something is divisible by 6, then it could be product of any number. So if, assuming j here is 2, then 2 times 6 gives us 12, which is also divisible by 6. Alright, so we write it in this form. Now having done the assumption, we can move on and look at the proving that the statement is true for n plus 1. Right. So for n equals k plus 1, we are proving that 10, so in this case k plus 1, because here we are looking at n equals k plus 1, so whenever we see n in the original expression, we're going to put the k plus 1. Minus 4 is divisible by what? 6. Alright. It is divisible by 6. Or in other words, you can see that 10k plus 1 minus 4 is equal to 6, maybe r. What r belongs to the set of natural numbers. So as I said earlier, if it is actually divisible by 6, then we can multiply it by any number, and any number multiplied by 6 is divisible by 6. Good, so we box on and look at the main proof, the actual proof. So main proof. Yeah. So what are we trying to do? To show that this one is equal to 6r. That's what we're trying to do, that this side is equal to it. So we have 10 to the power k plus 1 minus 4. And we want to see whether it is actually equal to 6r. So you move, we work from the left and see whether whatever we're going to get here will be 6r. And what is 6r? We don't have any problem. Now then we'll go back to our knowledge in indices. And when we are there, we can look at this as being written as 10 to the power k multiplied by 10, because we recall that when the bins are the same and we are multiplying, then we can add the powers. So this is to power 1. So we can add and get back to where we come from. And so minus 4, we have something like that. So remember, to actually prove this, we need to bear in mind our assumption at this stage. We're saying that for n equals k, we are assuming that this one is divisible by 6, in which we have written in this form. Right, so we're trying to see if from here we can get something similar to 10 to the power k minus 4. And so our effort will lead us into saying that, okay, let's factor 10 out. Even though 10 is not common, we can put 10 out. And when that is done, realize that here we'll be left with 10 to the power k. But because we are interested in using the assumption, we'll pretend and put here negative 4. Now, knowing fully well that when this is expanded, this times this gives us this back. But this times this will actually give us negative 40, which is not the same here. Here you have negative what? Negative 4. Alright, so it means we are committing a certain error. The error we have made here is that instead of writing here, we are now getting negative 40 instead of negative 4. So to cater for that, we bring plus 36. So that if you expand this, this and this gives us this one. Now this gives us negative 40. Then plus 36 will give us negative 4. Yeah, good. Now having done that, realize that what is here, k, 10 to the power k minus 4. At this stage, we said that it should be equal to 6g. So if 10 raised to the power 4 minus k equals 6g, then you can lift 6g and work carefully and place it here. So that at the end of the day, we now have 10 multiplying 6g, then plus what? 36. Now we don't know what 6j, or we don't know what j stands for, don't know its value, but all that we know is that 6 is here and it's multiplying 10, j, then 36. But realize that at this point we can factor 6 out because 6 is common to this term and 6 is also common to this term. So factoring 6 out, we have 6 here. And we are left with 10j plus, so 6 goes here, I mean, 6 times. So this is what we have now. Now to conclude the proof, realize that you can let all these one here be equal to a certain variable r, because we are proving that all this should be equal to 6r. So letting 10j plus 6 to be equal to r, so that let 10j plus 6 be equal to what? R. So R is a member of the set of natural numbers. So it means that we're going to have 6R, which is actually equal to what we have here, 6R. So the proof is there. So at this stage, we can confidently conclude so that for all n belonging to the set of natural numbers, then 10 power n minus 4 is divisible by 6. Alright, so that ends it. The proof is done. And that'll be all for now. Catch you again in the next lesson where we look at more examples on this. Thank you very much.